Hello everyone, I am Shankar Reddy, Chief Medical Physicist and Radiation Safety Officer of Artemis Hospital. Today I am going to talk about radiation safety.
The main content of this program is what is radiation, where it is located, effects of radiation, who is the regulatory body, how to protect from radiation and how to measure the dose received by radiation worker. First of all, we have to know what is radiation. Radiation is energy released in the form of particles or electromagnetic waves. There are two types of radiation, non-ionizing and ionizing. Non-ionizing radiation doesn't have sufficient energy to break the bonds of orbital electrons. Microwaves, radio waves, UV rays, lasers, etc. comes under this category. Ionizing radiation means it has sufficient energy to break the bonds of orbital electrons. Alpha particles, beta particles, neutrons, gamma rays and X-rays are examples of ionizing radiation. This is a spectrum of radiations. Up to ultraviolet rays we are calling as non-ionizing radiation. Beyond ultraviolet rays we are calling as ionizing radiation. These are the penetration abilities of different types of ionizing radiation. Radiation has wide range of applications in healthcare. In Artemis Hospital we are using 30 radiation generating equipments for diagnosis, treatment and blood irradiation. Now I will introduce the radiation facilities available in our hospital floor wise. Radiation oncology department located in lower ground floor. Here we are having two linear accelerators for radiotherapy treatment. Shortly we are calling them as LA1 and LA2. Both LAs can deliver high energy radiation typically in the range of 6 to 15 MV. CyberKnife is an advanced robotic radiation system capable to do non-invasive radio surgery. Brachytherapy unit in radiation oncology department uses high dose rate iridium-182 radioactive source to treat cancer. Nuclear medicine department located in lower ground floor. Here we are having PET CT, gamma camera and we are using radioactive isotopes like FDG, technetium, iodine, gallium and lutetium. Next, diagnostic radiology department located in ground floor. We are having a fixed X-ray unit, fluoroscopy unit, mammography unit, bone marrow densitometer, CT scan unit and 4 mobile X-ray units. All these units generate low energy X-rays for diagnostic purpose. Please note, MRI and ultrasound machines are not listed here because they cannot generate ionizing radiation. Dental department also located in ground floor. Here we are having 2 intraoral machines and 1 OPG machine. We are having a biplane DSA unit in neuro OT located in ground floor. Then I am coming to first floor. In OT we are having 2 C-arms and 1 O-arm. Cardiology department located in second floor. We are having 2 interventional radiology units. Lithotripsy department located in third floor with 1 C-arm and another C-arm is there in endoscopy department. Radiation is present in the environment which is called as background radiation. Around 82% of background radiation is from natural sources, majority from radon gas. Other natural sources are uranium, thorium, potassium elements in earth crust and cosmic rays from solar system. Remaining 18% background radiation is from man-made sources like medical X-rays and nuclear power plants. So, we are living with 2 to 3 millisievert of background radiation coming from natural and man-made sources. Radiation can kill us if background radiation increases to 4000 millisievert. Here, millisievert is a unit of radiation. How radiation can affect our body? It can cause cancer, genetic effects, infertility, etc. Radiation effects are classified into two types. First one is deterministic effect. It has particular threshold limit. If you cross the limit, effect will come. Skin burns, cataract, infertility are the few examples. Second one is stochastic effect. It is probabilistic in nature. It may occur and may not occur. Cancer, genetic effects are the few examples of stochastic effects. This is a chart of deterministic effects. Central arrow indicates the level of observed radiation. Left side is the effects of partial body exposure and right side is the effects of full body exposure. If a person receives around 100 rad, he will get nausea and vomiting. If it is 1000 rad, bone marrow syndrome will come. If it goes near 10,000 rad, central nervous system will damage and person will die. So, who is the regulatory body? How to control the radiation effects? Answer is AERB, Atomic Energy Regulatory Board. It is Indian regulatory body that regulates and controls the radiation exposures. We are also having local radiation safety committee in Artemis Hospital. This is a short video about AERB.
Atomic Energy Regulatory Board, that is AERB, is a Government of India organization that enforces regulations to ensure radiation safety in the country. it has laid down requirements that are provided in its safety code for medical X-rays.
Few years back, AERB introduced ILORA web-based application for registration, licensing and other regulatory processes. All radiation workers are requested to register in ILORA. Link is given here. Then we are coming to safe doses of radiation. These dose limits are given by AERB. For radiation worker, dose limit is 20 millisievert per year, averaged over 5 years. For general public, it is 1 millisievert per year. For trainees, dose limit is 6 millisievert per year. For pregnant radiation worker, dose limit is 1 millisievert because we are considering her fetus or embryo as general public. There is no dose limit for patients because benefit is more than risk. If any female radiation worker is pregnant, do not hesitate to contact Radiation Safety Committee of Artemis Hospital to switch her working location to non-radiation area. How to protect yourself from radiation? These are the three radiation protection basics: time, distance and shielding. Effect of time. Less time, less radiation exposure. So pre-plan the procedure to minimize the exposure time. Effect of distance. More distance, less radiation exposure. It is advisable to stand as far as away from radiation source. Carrying boxes, forceps and remote handling tools should be used to keep the distance. Shielding significantly reduces the radiation dose. We are having sufficient personal protective equipment PPE in our hospital. Mobile lead barriers, lead aprons, thyroid collars, lead goggles, gonad shields and lead gloves are comes under PPE. Don't fold lead aprons and don't dump on floor. Keep them on hangers of PPE stand. These are the results of improper storage of lead aprons. Radiation protection in radiography procedures. Always work behind the protective barrier. In mobile radiography, use extendable control cable. Operate the CT equipment from control console. Operate the mammography unit behind the mobile barrier. Radiation protection in fluoroscopy procedures. Interventional radiologist and cardiologist are most likely personnel to get the highest annual doses.
Staff dose increases with inappropriate X-ray tube positioning. Keep the X-ray tube under the couch. This provides better protection from scattered radiation. Avoid standing on the tube side for oblique and horizontal X-ray beam. Stand on the side of the transmitted beam, that is, on the side of the imager. Transmitted beam contains only a small fraction of incident radiation and its respective scatter. This also helps in reduction in dose to the eye. Avoid putting your hand in direct X-ray beam. The couch hanging lead flaps, lateral shield and ceiling suspended glass attenuates the radiation reaching the operator to a large extent.
Video of patient protection in fluoroscopy.
Maximizing the distance between the X-ray tube and the patient and minimizing the distance between the patient and the imager will help in reducing the radiation dose. Step on the paddle only when looking at the screen. Collimate the X-ray beam to the area of interest. Collimation also reduces scatter radiation and improves image quality. Minimize the fluoroscopy time and monitor the DAP, that is, dose area product values. Minimize the number of frames and cine runs to clinically acceptable levels. Employ last image hold to review clinical findings. Spread the dose by rotating X-ray tube around the patient to avoid high skin dose. Exposing the same area in different projections may lead to skin injuries like radiation burns. Magnification mode, when used in image intensifier, results in higher patient dose. Be aware that patient will receive more skin dose in magnification mode. Oblique projections and thicker body parts increase skin dose of patient. So try to avoid extreme oblique projection if possible.
Radiation protection in nuclear medicine procedures. there are two types of exposures in nuclear medicine department, internal and external. In nuclear medicine department, we are handling unsealed radioactive isotopes, which can enter into body by inhalation or ingestion. So, no eating and no drinking in nuclear medicine department to avoid internal exposure. To avoid external exposure, use syringe seals and vial shields to reduce the dose up to 80%. Send the patient to isolation room after injecting radioactive isotopes to limit the exposure to other people. Because after injecting isotopes, patient will become radioactive. We have to make efforts to limit the exposure to as low as reasonably achievable. ALARA. Next, we are coming to radiation detection. You can't see the radiation, you can't smell the radiation, and you can't sense the radiation. Only way is radiation signs and monitoring devices. This trifile sign is for radioactive sources, and this tube sign is for X-rays. These are the radiation monitoring devices: survey meter, contamination monitor, zone monitor, and pocket dosimeter. For all radiation workers, we are providing TLD batches for personal monitoring. This is a short video of TLD badge.
A TLD badge is a radiation dose measuring device that enables us to know whether we are working within the dose limits. Make sure you always wear your own TLD badge at chest level. Above the badge, you must wear a lead apron. It attenuates X-ray and reduces radiation dose during X-rays imaging. For added safety, use thyroid shields and protective goggles.
All radiation workers have to wear the TLD badges. TLD badge will not protect you from radiation. It will give us how much dose you received. Thank you.